lately, an album, a children's book, and the most important production of all, adding a fourth child to her family, Remy Alexander. Please welcome Kelly Clarkson. Welcome, Kelly Clarkson.
I'm trying to do that gracefully. It didn't work out. Okay.
It's rather graceful.
I have this in black. Yeah, I saw you and I was like, I love that shirt. Yeah.
I didn't pick it out.
It's so comfortable, but cute.
It's very cute.
That's my thing.
Now, in the last 3 years, life has been good to you.
Yes.
You have been married.
It's been amazing.
You have four kids total. You've had two.
What?
Yeah. But most of your life, you said you didn't think you'd maybe become a mom or be a wife. What changed?
I thought I'd probably, even my mom is still like, you have children. I was very much a gypsy. I just loved traveling. My job was kind of perfect for me in that sense. And I'm very like, I had a very high bar, like for if I was gonna date someone, because I have a great life, and I'm like, oh, if I'm gonna add someone to it, you're gonna have to bring something. I'm like, everybody got a great life going on. So, but he was, he's amazing, and so, and his kids are amazing, and they made me want to have kids, and now we have two more. Yeah,
yeah, you have,
yeah. Is two and Remy B is 5 months. They're backstage right now. Oh my gosh. Because I wouldn't have been able to see them all day if I didn't bring your kids to work day, because I'm working until like late tonight.
Yeah. So. That's good.
Such a good mom.
You know, talking about your husband Brandon.
It's hard.
You say it's hard. Marriage is hard. Everything's hard. So when you're talking about Brandon,
it should be a book.
There's a quote that you said, you know, what was it again? I mean, Brandon is not my other half. He's a whole person, I'm a whole person.
Yeah, I know.
So elaborate on that. It's fun.
Well, I mean, I was doing this interview. Excuse me. I was doing this interview and the lady was like, oh, so you found your other half. And I was like, no. I was like, I'm a whole person. I came out that way. And, and I don't know. I love, like I said, I'm a very strong individual. My daughter is just like me. It's very much karma. But I'm just my whole being, and he's whole, and we make a great team.
Yeah.
And that's our thing. We want to be a great team.
Isn't it insulting when they say your better half? Yeah. What does that mean?
He's just assessed to him. So I don't mind it so much, but no, it is. It's weird that they always say your other half, because I have a lot of single friends too, and you know, it's like they're fine. They're not missing anything, you know.
And you also have something. I love the relationship that you have with your husband. You say you guys don't have, or you have an oxygen mask mentality. And I want to read something that you said. You said, quote, I always
be on baby air.
Okay, there you go. See, Mark Cuban, call Kelly and Whoopi. But you said, quote, I always swore that ours would not be a relationship in which we have to schedule sex. We are never going to be that couple who puts the kids at work first in our relationship. Okay, my household, we have to. We call it ministry time. So how do you maintain, how do you maintain spontaneity? You have four kids.
I'm sorry, let's go back to ministry time. I wanted to attend that church.
It's a religious experience.
It is. Yeah. Well, I minister to him and he ministers to me. But I'm taking notes here. How do we get the spontaneity back?
That's just key for us. It comes back to the whole oxygen mask thing. I'm like, save yourself first, then help the children. Because we're going to be bad parents if we're not sexually pleased and we're not like having a good life, you know, we're gonna be bad. That's gonna bleed into other things, and you've got to have a great life. I'm sorry, painted an image. You're welcome.
She painted the
image.
I'm sorry. It is important, though. Like, people don't realize, like, sex is a very key part of a relationship. I mean, I have friends. Like, I don't need another friend.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. I need
babies
a lover.
Not in the bed.
No, well not done. At all.
Good. Yeah. So now you made a huge announcement that you have a new label, Atlantic Records.
Yes.
14 Woo! Years.
Yeah.
And you're doing You're doing amazing, wonderful stuff, are you not?
I am. I'm doing just, I honestly, I think people have been expecting this record from me since Idol, because all I sang was like Aretha Franklin and like soulful classics, like, and I wanted to do a contemporary version of that, and, well, 14 years later I get to, but it took a minute, but we're finally making the record I've been wanting to make since I was in like junior high, so.
Oh, yeah, it sounds so good so far.
Your voice has been like rocking my world since the American Idol days. Like, in my next life, basically, I want to be you. I've been telling everybody after the years, but to celebrate your.
A lot of hurdles coming.
I'm ready. If I can sing like you, I can handle anything. But to celebrate your upcoming record, you sang songs by Aretha Franklin,
yeah.
And you posted them on social media for people to see. And if anyone had any doubt that you could soul sing, that you could be amazing,
yes.
Now they know. Wow, can we take a look?
Yes, go.
Giving him something he can feel, yeah. To let him know my love is real, yeah. Oh, giving him something he can feel, to let him know my love is real, oh, yeah.
Just so everybody's really clear, music is the thing that connects everybody. Soul music is sung by kids in Japan. It's sung by music is everybody's domain.
Yeah.
So your voice is brilliant, and this is why we knew you. That's how we met you.
Exactly. So that's
and
why
so
I'm very excited. Yeah, and the whole new record, it's just something that, it's so funny. I was with my background singers. We were recording the BGVs for a couple songs that are coming out on this record, and it's just so funny because it's just as rangy as all my stuff, if not more, but it's effortless.
Yeah.
It's not hard to sing because it's so innate in you. Yeah, it's just in you.
Yeah.
And it's just so wonderful, and I deserve this record.
Yes, you do.
So you've got a new label, you've got a new children's book. We want to talk about that.
Do, yes.
Sarah is holding it up, Sarah.
Yes.
It's called River Rose and the Magic Lullaby.
Yes.
Yes. And it's named after your daughter. So how did this whole idea for a kids' book come about?
Well, it was actually just for her. We were traveling everywhere and her passport was like loaded with stamps that she's never going to remember anywhere, you know? And I was like, oh, I'll just be, you know, a dork mom and like, dude, I was like, what? I was like, it wasn't that great of a story. it's a picture. I get it. I got you. No, but anyway, I wrote these stories specifically for her. And it was just when she started reading, she could read them and see her pictures, and she was there.
Nice.
But and then everybody was like, "You should make a children's book," and I was like, "I should."
And you dedicated it to your mother.
I did. Well, she's a teacher, and I prize educators above all jobs. So, it's a hard, it's a thankless job.
Yeah.
Because everybody, I got in a very heated debate at a dinner one time because they were like, oh, well, teachers get 3 months off. And I was like, you know what?
No
way. They don't. They go to workshops. They go to class. They have to do everything to prepare for next year and take care of all 27 of your kids running around like crazy because you're not doing what you're supposed to at home.
Out of their own pocket.
Out of their own. And my mother would arrive early and help kids that needed help reading. Yeah. Like, she's just amazing.
Well, you're going to get Kelly to stay. No, because we're not ready for her to be done. So she's staying with us, and members of our audience are going home with her new book, River Rose and the Magic. We are back with Kelly Clarkson, and before we go, we want to ask you some fun, and I'm going to try to keep this quick questions.
Good luck.
Okay. What was your last Google search?
Oh, I was wanting to know, we were all having a debate of who sang, it was Carly Simon and James Taylor, and it was Mockingbird.
Celeb you've never met but want to?
Steve Carell, because I deserve it. He said my name.
Go-to karaoke song?
Erykah Badu, Tyrone.
I really wanted it to be Since You've Been Gone, but that's okay. Okay, Whoopi.
Me?
Tyrone.
No, I was done.
Sorry. Oh, you're done?
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Kelly Clarkson. I've asked Kelly to return to us when that album comes out, because you know she's going to tear it up. We want you all to know that we love that you're here. We want you to know that we want you to have a great day and take a little time to enjoy whatever view you happen upon.